Let's do an example. This is a swinging block mechanism. So we have a fixed pivot, we have a slider, and then we have a crank. Okay, so this is also a four bar mechanism. You can count the number of links over here. Ground is one, crank is two, this is number three, and that's four, right? And you can clearly see that there's relative motion between three and four. Okay, so what is given to you is, let's say, the angular velocity of the crank, we'll call it omega two, and we are looking for angular velocity of number four. So four and three, of course, they will have the same angular velocity. There's no difference between omega four and omega three. Let me just write that here so that's clear. Omega four is same as omega three, it's the same line. And we are looking at the rate at which this piston is sliding, or the slider is sliding. So we'll call it relative velocity with respect to link four. So that's the relative velocity as would be measured by an observer standing on link four and rotating with link four. But to that observer standing on link four, the motion of the piston would be a very simple one. That would be along the link four, right? So we have to solve for two unknowns here. Given is, let's write that, given is omega two, and we have to find omega four, which is same as omega three, and we relative. Okay, so we have two unknowns over here. We have to generate one vector equation at least, which will give us two scalar equations involving these two unknowns, and hopefully we can solve them. So the general method says that when you are solving for kinematics of rigid bodies moving in a plane, you have to apply a test to see which kind of reference frame you should use. And the test says that if you have sliding happening on a rotating rigid body, then we will pick a rotating reference frame. And in this case, we can clearly see there is a slider, and that slider is rotating on link number 4/3. So that means we should use a rotating reference frame. Then the next question is, how should we align our reference frame? And like I said before, in the general method, we should align our reference frame with the rotating rigid body. So we'll say this is O, this is X, this is Y. Okay. And now, once we have shown this, we can identify the motion of different rigid bodies. So we have crank. Crank is simply doing the rotation. So if this point is O, let's call this point P, and we'll call this point Q. Okay. So P is definitely rotating about Q in a center, because crank is doing a simple rotation. The motion of a 4 and 3, a combined link, is a combination of rotation. So 4 is rotating and 3 is also rotating, but the slider is sliding on the link number 3, right? Okay. Then we have the common points. So the common points are P over here, which is common to link number 2 and 3. Common point is O, and common point is Q. So O and Q are the trivial points. So we'll write the velocity of the P and the acceleration of P from the perspective of different rigid body. So let's look at the crank first. So crank 2, velocity of P is equal to velocity of Q plus omega 2 cross R of P with respect to Q. And since we picked the rotating reference frame, we also have relative velocity, but in this case, you can see that distance between P and Q doesn't change because P and Q belong to the same rigid body. This is actually zero, right? And we also say the Q is also zero because it's a fixed point. So we have omega 2 k hat cross R P with respect to Q. Now, what is that position vector? So we need to know this length. Let's say this length is L2, and at this instant, this is making an angle of theta from horizontal. Okay? So now you may be tempted to actually write R of P is in Q in the following way. Okay, so you resolve it along I direction and J direction. But you will notice that when we wrote this, we essentially assumed that we had a reference frame that was pointing like this, right? I and J, and that's how we wrote this position vector. But that is actually wrong. Why it is wrong? Because we have already picked our reference frame, and that is how we have shown it. And that means that every vector quantity now has to be written in our chosen reference frame, okay? So you can't mix different reference frame. And this is a mistake that students make a lot, actually. I've seen it in my teaching of dynamics in the last 10 plus years.
So be very careful about this. Once you show a reference frame, you have to write every vector quantity in that particular reference frame. So now how do we fix it? So what is really R of P with respect to Q? So let's draw this reference frame separately, okay? Because I want to show this to you. So this is small o, this is y, and this is x, all right? And let's say this is making an angle of alpha from horizontal, okay? And in fact, this is something you can do too, in case you think that you will forget to write the vectors properly in your chosen reference frame. You can always draw the reference frame separately, you know, draw the axis bigger, and then you can show your various quantities. Now, R of P with Q is this vector, which is pointing at an angle theta from horizontal, right? So what is that vector? So let's say it is this. This is R of P with Q, and it's making an angle theta here, all right? Okay, so now what we have to do is we have to really resolve this along this direction and this direction, right? So the question is now, what is the angle that the theta is making from y-axis, let's say, right? So let's say, what is this angle? This is gamma. So we know that, you know, theta plus gamma, this is 90 degree, plus alpha is equal to what, 180? So we get gamma equal to 90 minus alpha minus theta. And that's gamma, right? So which means that R of P with respect to Q, this vector, is really L2 cosine gamma, and that's along j-hat direction, and we have minus sine gamma i-hat, right? That's R of P with Q in the i-hat and j-hat quadrant system that we have shown here, okay? If you write this, that would be wrong, okay? So that gives us the velocity of P. Let's write that again. Equal to omega 2 k-hat cross L2 cosine gamma j-hat minus sine gamma i-hat. Okay, let's simplify this. Take the cross product. K cross j is minus i-hat minus sine gamma j-hat. And that's velocity of P. Okay, let's call this equation 1. So this is velocity of the point P with respect to the Crank number 2, right? So that's one perspective. Now what we would like to do is we would like to write the velocity of the point P from another perspective. And in this case, we will choose the link number 3 and 4, okay? So let's write velocity of P choosing O as a reference point, which by the way is a fixed point. This is a point O right over here where we have the origin of our reference frame, plus omega 4 cross R of P with respect to O plus relative velocity, right? Now, what is the relative velocity? Relative velocity is the rate at which the distance between point P and O would be changing. And that is clearly not zero, because as this mechanism moves, the distance between P and O is going to change, right? Okay, so let's write this. Omega 4 is an unknown. Let's assume it's positive. Cross R of P with such O, what is that vector? So that is basically this vector from here to here, right? This is the vector. So we need to know what this length at this instant is. So remember, we are doing instantaneous analysis. Of course, this length is going to change, but at this particular instant, we will be given a length. Let's say that's L3. And L3 is pointing along i-hat direction. V relative is something we don't know, but we know it's positive i-hat, right? Well, we don't know it's positive i-hat. We just know it's i-hat. If our guess is right, it'll be positive. If guess is wrong, it'll be negative. Okay, so that's VP. Let's simplify it. Omega 4 L3, K cross I is J, and this is V relative I hat. So one thing you would notice is, let's call this equation 2, is that, you know, writing equation 2 was actually simpler than equation 1, right? Why? Because, you know, equation 1, we had this vector R of P with Q, which we had to resolve in a quadrant system that was oriented at an angle from horizontal. On the other hand, pretty much all the vector quantities in this equation are aligned with moving reference frame. So you pay one way or another, right? So in this case, you know, our life became simpler when we wrote the velocity of the P in the moving reference frame, but velocity P from the perspective Crank was slightly harder to write because we had to resolve our vectors. Okay, so now both 1 and 2 are expressions of velocity of the point P, and they have to be same, right? They cannot be different. These are absolute velocities as measured by a fixed or a primary reference frame. So even though we really didn't show primary reference frame over here, but primary reference frame is always present. So in this case, it's actually aligned with the moving reference frame, all right? So you can always draw both of them. That's not a problem. Okay, let's equate these two. So 1 equal to 2 leads to minus omega 2 L2 cosine gamma I hat plus sine gamma J hat equal to omega 4 L3 J hat plus V relative I hat, right? Now this is a vector equation, so we can write the coefficients of I hat on left hand side equal to coefficients of I hat on the right hand side, and the same thing with the coefficients of J hat. So what do we get? We get minus omega 2 L2 cosine gamma equal to V relative, and we get minus omega 2 L2 sine gamma equal to omega 4 L3. So V relative is, you know, obtained directly from here because omega 2 is known, L2 is known, gamma is known, and this gives you omega 4 as minus omega 2 L2 over L3 times sine gamma, right? And that solves the problem for you.